Okay, this is my FT8 and FT4 unnamed so far assistant, and I'm looking for beta testers. So what's going on here? Right, first of all, here are the colours. CQ callers are in a dull orange brown colour. I've just successfully worked the new country Lithuania, so new CQ callers, new countries are in blue, bright blue. If my call sign is in the received text, then it's bright green, and yellow is my transmission. So I worked Lithuania and unsuccessfully called new DXCC Iceland. So if we look at what's going on, right? Okay, note the overlay of the first three letters of the call sign in the wide graph. I will transmit on that frequency. That's the frequency showing here. When I called the Icelandic station, who is this fine fellow, it looked him up on QRZ. Note that was his frequency, time, etc. That's his Maidenhead. He was calling CQ minus 15 and 1800 kilometers away, 333 degrees. And notice that I've got auto QRG set, so it will find its own slot. And also it's telling me that the Icelandic station is using recently logbook of the world, and it's also telling me the location within Iceland of that station. Note that it highlighted that station also in the band activity. Okay, so what else? Right, well, right, here's my log. So there is what I've worked recently. Quite pleased with there's an American station there somewhere. Interesting. Well, that's today. Oh, there he is, right there. So there's the American station I worked this morning. Whoops. Right, so notice also that it's showing details of the QTH, where it can be worked out from the call sign. Right, so we'll get rid of that. Now there are three maps. Here's the world map. The squares are what I've recently heard during this session. Right, the two-letter squares are in brighter yellow if they are still not confirmed by LOTW. Notice it's telling me that Echo Mike Square is 6,000 kilometers away and 290 odd degrees. Right, now the small dots are those recently received in PSK Reporter. So likewise, on the Europe map, the red dots are squares I've worked before, four character squares, Maidenhead squares that I've worked before, and you can see the decal there, KM17, 2000 kilometres, 121 degrees, and in those parts of Greece. Okay, now this empty square is a square I have not worked, and if I wanted to, I could work OM3WBY, who is in a part of the Slovak Republic. That's not very good, that one. There we are, Austria. I can't read the, my eyeballs are bad. I can't read the location. You know, so, but he's minus 22, which is no good to anybody. So, so look at another one. There's a part of Spain, and he's minus 18. If I kill, no, wait, I'll wait for a while. And the small dots are PSK reporter reports. So this is 40 meters, which is a new band to me about last week with the indoors dipole. Okay, and oh yeah, that's the Icelandic station that I tried to work with the cross indicator over it. And of course, this is where I am in IO91. Okay, so so if I wanted, so there is a minus 18. So what's he? Minus 20. They're not good enough. Not good enough. There's a minus 16 station. Click. I can now see him highlighted. Oh, and it's gone back to the Icelandic. I don't know why. Clear that. Right. So what's going on here then? So this is. The band activity text split into four parts, right? And the emphasis here is on finding new DXCCs, new Maidenhead squares, both two character and four character, depending on the distance. Four character for Europe. Two character for the world. Okay, so you can see on this I'm hearing those two character squares. So I don't need this for a while. Put it down there. So this is finals. So notice that I've reconstructed the Maidenhead squares for those stations which I know about, which is about 30,000. The small letter W indicates that the call sign, that the station has recently reported to Logbook of the World. So over here is CQs. Now this might look a bit strange, but what I'm looking for is to tail end on new DXCCs, new Maidenhead squares, and new oblasts. Right. So what's an oblast? A Russian oblast is one of these, and this is a new band for me. And I've only actually worked Rostov Oblast, Rostovskaya, worked and confirmed in LOTW. So if I move the cursor about, you can see that it identifies the Russian federal regions, and you can work out the oblast from the call sign, so which I can't demonstrate because it's a bad morning on 40 meters. So anyway, right. So that's that. Showed you the log. Right. So what countries have I worked? This is work in progress. It's a tiny bit slow. Right, hurry up. There it is. Right, so here's my list of countries that I've heard, that I've worked and have been confirmed. So the emphasis that I have now is to find countries that I have worked, but I need LOT logbook of the world confirmations for. Okay, so and it's Europe at first, then USA. So I've only got one. I should have. Yeah, that's right. USA is confirmed. Big deal. Right, work in progress is another map of American states. Right. So what else? What else? Well, there's a lot of stuff. I can sometimes, by mistake, or because I can't help it, I miss the Maidenhead locator, so I can repair that. There's a couple of missing ones. Now I know that they're missing because they never ever broadcast their Maidenhead locator. So what I do, with the other ones, I think what they send a locator, and I also look up the locator on QRZ. And there is a discrepancy which I will investigate. Right, so I'm not going to do that. It takes about 10 seconds. I won't do that. However, the way to do that is to analyse traffic. So this is today's. I can choose. It's a bit weird, this one. So that's yesterday, I think. So today, and that's always on top, I shall notice what's so. I've got an issue here because it's not picking up the grid. Right, there we go. So that's me today. Get rid of that. So I have done seven QSOs, plus or minus, not plus. It's actually counting the number of 73s, which may be more than the number of QSOs. It's a minor point at the moment. So I have transmitted 47 packets, 13 of which are CQs, and 20 of which are TX1s. Okay, so the top performer this morning so far is the Swiss station, who has done 96 calls, CQs, and has had six ish finals, and the average distance per QSO is 950. There's the YU who's done quite well. It's a total kilometres of 50,000. Okay, I've only done 49,000, which actually looks quite good. But one of those was American. There he is. Seven. There's the 73s from the Echo Mike station. So yeah, so there you are, and there's the latest one. Okay, right, so we get rid of that. Right, delta time, and in some cases, mentioning no names, I might want to hide a call sign from here. Okay, so right, what else? Nothing on that one. Right, so what's going on up here? Let's see. This is my trace, right, program trace, right? And it's difficult to, I have to turn the monitor off, I think. Turn off the monitor. That will. So we go to the very top. Right, so here we are. So, pausing for a moment. Right, so starting here, it knows the user, turns on auto frequency. It looks at the LOTW user file, and after, if it's 5 days old, it grabs a new one. It's telling me there are no new LOTW confirmations. Then, Carl, it hides CQs of persistent CQ callers, which I have set up from another menu item. Okay, and it has loaded 26,000 known locators, so it can reconstruct the locators in finals and reports in the overs. Okay, so right, and sometimes it finds a Maidenhead for a station it doesn't know. So 40 meters, okay. So far 54 logged QSOs, right. 31 DXCCs, and this is in about less than 10 days. 15 MH2, as I call it. 46 Maidenhead 4. Worked, 23 confirmed already. Some people confirm within minutes, which is what I do. Other people can take a couple of years. It's extraordinary. Right, it detected this version. I'm using this version for because there's an issue with tail ending with later versions, and going through, it's done a PSK download, which is very fast, less than 1 second, and it downloaded 14 spots basically. Right, so if we look, right, that's incorrect. What I'm looking for is sorry about the pause. There we are. Right, okay. Logging. There's the Lithuanian station. I'm logging it to Logbook of the World, QRZ.com, Club Log, and EQSL. And it's giving me that's immediately after the QSO. So I'll turn the monitor back on. And the monitor back on. quite a lot going. That's in engineering. So as I say, I'm looking for beta testers, and that is actually quite helpful. This is actually quite stable. I've got a couple of niggling irritations with it, but nothing that is too serious. The crash rate is about once a week, I'm quite happy with it. So right, last I'll turn back. So here is a set of criteria. Right, get rid of that, which have to be met before it automatically responds. Okay, so there is the frequency that I'm transmitting on. If I and auto QRG is auto frequency select is on, and so I'm highlighting EA. I don't know why. I'll get rid of that. Right. Oh yeah. So armed. It will respond if the SNR now is minus 14 or better, right? And the distance, it will respond to any station that is more than 500 kilometers away. And I am only looking for new Maidenhead 2. So if I make that Maidenhead 4 instead, and it's armed, and we'll see what happens. Oh, by while it's waiting, there I can replay the entire session if I want to. There we go. It's found I've got an issue with finals, so it's found that German station, and it knows it's I've not worked in before, and it has a logbook of the world, and of course it's Germany. You know, while we're and there he is, there he is. Okay, and that goes away after a while, but it's not going to. It's supposed to answer finals, but there's an issue with me and it's come back again, still on finals. Right, so just to stop that, I'll increase the distance. Oh no, there we go, he's answering a minus 14 Switzerland. Okay, it's a new Maidenhead. Here we go. Oh yes, let's try again. Yeah, very good. Okay, see what happens here. No, he's not. He's unsurprisingly not going to answer. My power out isn't very good, I've just noticed. So give it one more. Nope, I shall end this video with this failure. It's better to work FT4 for demonstrations, by the way. Nope. Okay. I think I've covered everything. If I think of anything else, I'll pin it onto the end of this. Anyway, right. Thank you for watching. And be seeing you.